Hello, firearms friends. Welcome back, or should I say willkommen, to another video with Rock Island Auction Company. I'm Joel Kolander, and in preparing for some of these videos, I was talking with Kevin, and we both firmly agree in trying to highlight items, it's like drinking from a fire hose. There's so many amazing firearms in the September 2018 Premier Firearms Auction. There's high condition guns, rare guns, and guns with amazing stories to tell. And on the table in front of me today, we have some incredible German firearms with their own stories to tell. And so we'll just dive right in. First in front of me is an incredibly rare Luger firearm. Here we have a DWM pre-production 1902 Luger carbine, and not just any Luger carbine. This is a presentation Luger carbine. It should command attention for bearing the GL monogram on the back, Georg Luger. So this is a presentation from Georg Luger, and it fits into a very narrow serial number range, about 10. And these went to some of the most important men of the day. You had Luger carbines in this 10 number serial range going to people like President Theodore Roosevelt, President of Mexico Porfirio Diaz, Hiram Maxim, and we have this one as well. Now this one, likely with the gold monogram on the top of the chamber, went to Prince Alphonse of Bavaria. It bears a very similar golden A with a crown above it. But there is another fantastic story that follows this Luger, and it went to the Prince of Fürstenberg, Maximilian Egon II. Now, Maximilian Egon II had a very, very long name. Lots of middle names, lots of surnames that there's no way I'm going to remember. But he went by his family name, Anton, hence the A on the chamber. Now, the story goes, the Prince of Fürstenberg was in Constance, Germany, with some occupying French troops. French troops were celebrating, he was celebrating as well, and he hung his family banner out a window. Unfortunately for the Prince of Fürstenberg, his banner has the colors reversed of the French flag, and so it appeared to the occupying French troops that he was disrespecting their flag and hanging it upside down. So they were going to hang him. About that time, the governor or mayor of Constance, Andre Noel, came by, asked the French troops what they were doing. They told him, and he relayed to them their mistake and the miscommunication. In thanks, Prince of Fürstenberg named a street in his honor. That street still bears his name today in Constance. Now, the prince died in 1941, but his son Carl, in 1946, presented this Luger carbine to Governor Andre Noel in honor of saving his life. We know for a fact that this remarkable presentation Luger carbine has remained in the Noel family till about 2012, when it was sold by Sotheby's. I'd like to talk about a few of the accessories that come with it that are also incredibly rare. Mounted to it, you can see we do have a very early production stock with the push button release. There's thought to be only a handful that still exist. In front, we have a period leather case. And if you've seen any of the leather cases also from that period, they've seen better days. This one remains remarkably soft, supple leather and appropriate for the period between 1900 and 1904. We do have leather covering the rings as well as the buckle on front. It is a remarkable German piece, following a set of, again, of almost 10 serial numbers with the Georg Luger intertwined monogram on the back. It is an absolute gem for German collectors. Another piece that we couldn't help but include with all these fantastic German pieces is the helmet to my left. It does tend to garner some attention when you walk past it. It is a beautiful Prussian garde du corps bodyguard helmet. The King of Prussia's bodyguards would have worn these helmets. You can find photos of very important Imperial Germans wearing these helmets, Kaiser Wilhelm II, etc. It is a bronze helmet trimmed with silver. You have this beautifully, beautifully detailed and sculpted Imperial Eagle in silver sitting on top of its nickel base. There's also obviously the large silver crest in the front. Mit Gott für König und Vaterland, with God for King and the Fatherland, and the nice black Imperial German eagle that we've all come to know. It's a striking helmet. The detail on this eagle, it can't be overstated. When you can see the individual lines of each feather, you know you have something special, clearly intended for higher-ups or in the presence of higher-ups in Imperial Germany. And moving to my right, we have a German pistol of a different era, but with another great story. But before we get into the history, just looking at the pistol, clearly a presentation and beautifully done Walther PPK. We have a gold wash, we have this brilliant red case, we have a gold-plated magazine, gold rounds, and of course, this, as we see on other presentation, German Walthers from the time, this very Germanic oak leaf scroll. There's some geometric borders that make it up. The Walther address has not been obliterated. It's been kept, thankfully. Always nice to see that. A beautiful, beautiful Walther PPK. Where it comes from is an incredible story. This is a Walther PPK surrendered by Hermann Goering to American forces upon his surrender. Now, Hermann Goering at that time didn't have a whole lot of options for where to go. He was considered a criminal by the Germans, and the Russians were encroaching fast. And so his best option was to surrender himself to American forces. Now, Hermann Goering had two handguns that he planned to use for surrender. The first, a Smith & Wesson revolver. He planned on making in a formal surrender of Germany to the President of the United States or a high-ranking general. Obviously, he never got that chance with Admiral Dönitz taking the task for him. This beautiful golden Walther PPK was surrendered by Goering to the American forces as he was avoiding detection by the Russian and German forces in the area. Thankfully, previous custodians of this remarkable pistol have done their due diligence, and it is accompanied by almost chapters of provenance from the troops who saw this pistol being surrendered. To see that listed out in its entirety, please visit the item listing on www.rockislandauction.com, and while you're there, view the hundreds and hundreds of other incredible firearms that are available in this sale, not only, of course, in German military, but U.S. military, Winchesters, Colts, the military vehicles, the tanks, the collection of Allen Coors, and numerous other named collections. It's a sale you don't want to miss. On September 7th, 8th, and 9th, this sale is an absolute blockbuster, and you won't want to miss it.